Imagine you're at the top of a mountain and are trying to get down to the bottom. But there's an added twist. It's dark outside. Don't panic. You can't see the general landscape, but you can see the ground right around you. You can look a short distance to the north, south, east, and west, and see what the slope is where you're standing. What strategy would you use to get down the fastest? It turns out that machine learning researchers face this problem all the time. Well, they're not on actual mountains, but they do write computer programs with a similar idea. The programs describe a function, like the height of a mountain, and the goal is to get to the bottom as quickly as possible. Just like walking at night, the programs can only see the slope right around them. So, did you think of a strategy to get down? Let's take it one step at a time. Literally. A good strategy is to look around you and observe the slope in each direction. Then, take a step in the direction with the steepest downward slope. You're now at a new location and closer to the bottom. Then, you can look at the slope in each direction again and take a step in the direction with the steepest downward slope. If you keep repeating this process, you'll eventually get to a point where the slope is either zero or positive all around you. In other words, if you take a step in any direction, you'd either maintain or increase your height. Finally, you can rest knowing you're at the lowest altitude around you. This process is exactly what machine learning scientists and mathematicians call gradient descent. Descent refers to moving downward on a surface or slope, and gradient is just another term for slope in math. It's used for many different types of problems. For example, finding the fastest shipping routes or minimizing costs in a large company. In machine learning, the same idea is used to minimize another type of cost: how wrong a neural network's predictions are based on a set of data. After minimizing this error, the neural net is said to have learned the data, and then it can be used for new data it hasn't seen before. In this context, you'll often hear the term backpropagation, which describes how the gradients or slopes are computed in a neural network. But no matter how the slope is determined, if you're following the steepest downward slope, you're using gradient descent. This idea is so powerful that many variants have been developed. For example, some approaches adapt their step size based on the gradient to try and find the lowest spot more quickly. Others start in several random locations to avoid getting trapped in what might seem to be the lowest spot, but is actually just a dip in the local landscape with an even lower spot located farther away. All these powerful ideas come from the simple intuition of following the steepest downward slope to get to the bottom of a mountain.